In this video, I'm going to be walking you through step-by-step how to use Boolean searches on LinkedIn. Okay, so what are Boolean searches? Boolean searches allow you to combine words and phrases using the words and, or, not, parentheses, or quotation marks known as operators to limit, broaden, or define your search results. So these are five different operators, and or not, parentheses, and quotation marks, that allow you to either limit, broaden, or define your search results so that you can spend your time on LinkedIn as efficiently as possible. Boolean searches can be stacked upon one another or used in multiple search features inside of LinkedIn to get hyper-specific and relevant with your targeting. So I'm gonna go through examples at the very end of this video here of how to find both clients and talents using Boolean searches in LinkedIn, and we're gonna go through step-by-step, starting very broad, how I would take one key phrase and add these different Boolean operators in order to get it refined down so I'm spending my time on LinkedIn as efficiently as possible and only reaching out to the most qualified people as possible. So where can you use Boolean searches? The two most powerful places that we found to use Boolean searches are current and past job titles on LinkedIn and keywords in articles. Anywhere else, it doesn't really make sense to use Boolean searches inside of there. However, just those two by themselves, you can have literally hundreds of different of combinations depending on how many keywords you use. So let's start with what I consider to be the most important operator, which is the quotation operator. Okay, this is the most important one as it can help you narrow down your search results the fastest. So using quotation marks allow you to find exact phrases in your searches. For example, if I'm searching by job titles and I search for chief operating officer without any quotation marks, then LinkedIn may show me many people who even have just one of these keywords. So chief executive officer or chief tech officer. So they just have to have the words chief or operating or officer inside of their job titles, and LinkedIn's gonna show me all those results. So there could be tens of millions of people that fall in this category. However, if I just wanna be finding chief operating officers, I can use quotation marks around chief operating officer, and then it will only pull profiles with these keywords in this exact order. So then it would only find me people that had the title inside their title, chief operating officer, those three words in those three sequence there in my search results. And of course that would only appear if somebody was a chief operating officer. So this is why this is the most important one of the different ones we're gonna walk through here, because even if you do some of the other ones to either narrow down or broaden out your scope, if the actual Boolean search, if the search feature doesn't know which part of these are supposed to be together, then you could have very, very wonky search results, okay? Now, the only time you may want to consider not using quotation marks would be if you're targeting more of an industry in general and you don't want to limit your options. So I might not want to say real estate agent. If I can serve anybody in real estate, whether they're an agent, they're a broker, they're commercial, they're residential, then I might just want to type in the title real estate without any quotation marks on it, because that will give me the most broad search results without any limitations. But if I was only going after real estate agents, then I might want to do real estate agent all in one quotation so I can make sure those keywords are together. Now let's talk about the and operator. Okay, so we just talked about quotations. Let's talk about the and operator. This operator is used to narrow down your search results by requiring all of those keywords to be present. So that means that if the profile has only one or the other, it will not populate in your search results. So this is helpful if your target market is incredibly broad, or if you have a difficult time finding keywords that can be strung together to be filtered by. So let me give you an example here. If I was looking for real estate professionals, but only in the commercial sector, right? So I want real estate professionals because I serve those people, but I only serve real estate professionals in the commercial sector, I may use the keywords real estate and commercial. Okay, so you see that, notice there, I use the keywords and the quotation marks real estate, but then I add the and to add commercial in there as well, so that the profiles have to have the word commercial in their title in order for me to service them. Now, in this example, just to show you so you understand this a little bit better, I would not want to use commercial real estate above in this example, because that could narrow down the results too much. Because if someone had in their results real estate agent and then like maybe a pipe and then it's a commercial after that, or they had commercial somewhere in another different part of their title, then by saying quotation commercial real estate, I'm excluding all those people out there. So by separating them into two different and statements, I'm allowed to have a larger pool of people that I'm likely to pull from while still being narrow enough to only be in the commercial industry. So let's go down to the OR operator now, okay? So the OR operator is used to broaden your search results, allowing any of these keywords to be present. This is helpful if your market is specific, but they go by different names or by different titles. For example, if I was going after the owner or the founder of a company, I can service any owner or founder in the world. Let's say I'm a merchant processing service. Then I want to go after all of the owners and founders of our companies, but I can't just start with the title CEO, because that would limit down what people call themselves. As we all know, people call themselves multiple different things if they're the owners and founders. So I might put something like CEO or chief executive officer or owner or founder or entrepreneur. And you can keep on going down and deeper and deeper and deeper in that rabbit hole. So that way we can search all of them at the same time in one key search result. Because the benefit of Boolean searches is if you're able to get a large broad pool and then go narrower based on different search features inside of LinkedIn. So for example, maybe this was what I was searching for, this OR feature inside of LinkedIn Sales Navigator using Boolean searches, but then I only wanted people that had 3 to 5 years of business experience. So then I could add that filter, and now I took a list that's probably in the tens of millions and brought it down to maybe in the millions. But it keeps it a lot easier if I have one list with all these titles together versus 30 different lists all with different titles, okay? In this example here, if we used and in this example, we'd likely yield no results. So that's the difference between and or. So if I said CEO and chief executive officer and owner and founder and entrepreneur, then it's very unlikely, unless somebody is like very full of themselves, that they would say, I'm the CEO, chief executive officer, and the owner and the founder and the entrepreneur of this company, right? Nobody would have that in their title. And so you wouldn't use and in this example, you would use or, okay? Let's talk about the not operator now. This operator is used to narrow your search results, requiring these keywords not to be present. So these keywords cannot be present. That's what you're pretty much telling LinkedIn when you're making the search result. This is very helpful if while you're narrowing your search, you frequently come across keywords that are cluttering up your results. So if you search for something and you're trying to kind of keep on narrowing down, and this one specific job title or keyword keeps on popping up, instead of trying to create all these variations of how it could not pop up, you could just add in not that keyword, and then that would disappear from all of your search results, okay? So for example, almost any job title search of real estate would yield thousands of different titles for different professions. And let's say that we do want to target some real estate agents, like a good majority of them, but we don't want to service specific ones, then this is when the not would come into use here. So I would search real estate because I can search a lot of them, but let's say I don't serve tax real estate professionals. So in some way or the other, they have the word tax and real estate inside of their title, but let's say maybe I just have something against tax real estate professionals. I can say not tax, and that way it can prevent me from finding anybody inside of there that are real estate tax professionals that have those keywords in there. So this is very helpful if you're trying to narrow down your search results and you keep on finding one pesky little keyword popping up or one type of person popping up over and over again. You can use the word not, and that'll remove them totally from your search results, okay? And finally, let's talk about the parentheses operator. So I'm gonna take you back to high school math for 1 second here. But this operator is used to select the order of operations, if you remember algebra, for your Boolean searches. So similar to math, the order in which you execute operations matter. For example, if I say 2 plus 6, 3 times 6, Without any parentheses, that equals 20. However, if I just add a parentheses to the 2 plus 3, and then I multiply that times 6, that equals 30. So just by adding parentheses, we have two totally different answers here. And that's exactly the same thing for Boolean searches. So you have real estate agent in quotes and commercial or industrial, so none of these have parentheses, and this is pretty much telling LinkedIn, find me people that are real estate agents and they have the word commercials, or they have industrial in their profile. So I could just get people that have industrial in their profile. They don't even have to have real estate agent, and they don't even have to have commercial. So in this example here, this or could cancel out this and statement right here. So it's kind of confusing, and that's how you mess up your Boolean searches. If instead I say real estate agent in quotation marks and then parentheses, commercial or industrial, I'm saying that I want you to find me people that have real estate agent in their title and they need to have either commercial or industrial in addition to that. Okay, so I'm gonna say that one more time. Previously, we're saying, without parentheses, we're saying, hey, I'm looking for real estate agents and people that have commercial in their title, or they could just have industrial, they don't need real estate agent or commercial, which is not what I'm looking for. Or by adding the parentheses, I could say, real estate agent has to be there and either commercial or industrial. So it could be real estate agent commercial, or it could be real estate agent industrial, and those would all populate in this search result, okay? So you can start stringing these all together, these different ands, ors, parentheses, quotation marks, to get incredibly specific with whom you're targeting. But I always recommend doing this in a separate document first so that you can identify what went wrong. Because sometimes what happens is you'll string together. I mean, I've had 50 or 60 of these inside one single string, and then I put it inside LinkedIn and LinkedIn errors it out and it just erases everything. So my one recommendation would be learn from my mistakes, type this out in a notepad or in a Google document first. It'll allow you to kind of analyze it a little bit better and then just copy and paste it in LinkedIn. So that all being said, let's actually walk through an example of what this looks like. So I'm inside of LinkedIn Sales Navigator, as you can see right here. And you can see on the left-hand side, I have underneath roles, I have current job titles. So it says add current titles right here on the bottom left. So let's go back and let's just walk through what these different Boolean searches could do. So I'm gonna start with real estate, right? So let me just copy this. So let's just type in real estate and their current titles, no quotation marks, I just want real estate. If I were to look at this, the total search results here have over 1 million people, okay? So there's 1 million people that have real estate. You can see I have director of operations and real estate development, real estate consultancy, licensed real estate salesperson, a real estate agent, a real estate investor. So obviously a bunch of different people in a bunch of different instances. Okay, maybe I wanna service just real estate agents. So let's go back in here again and let's erase this real estate, and instead let's add in the quotation marks real estate agent. Okay, so now when this loads back again, the old one was 1 million, this one is 380,000. So you can see this one says luxury real estate agent, this one says residential and commercial real estate agent, this one says rental property manager and real estate agent, licensed real estate agent. So now we're getting more into actual real estate agents, but it's not as narrow as I wanted, right? There's still a bunch of kind of random people all in different areas here. So let's come down here and let's say I only service luxury real estate professionals, okay? So then I'm gonna clean this one out. I'm gonna come back in here and type in real estate agent, and I want the word luxury because I only service people that are real estate agents in luxury markets, and I'm gonna assume they have the word luxury in their title when they do that. So now you can see we have 999 search results, and these have luxury real estate agent, luxury real estate agent, luxury real estate agent, luxury real estate agent. So we're really starting to get and narrow down to exactly who we're going after here, okay? But let's kick it up a notch, if you will, okay? Let's say that we want either agents or brokers, right? So if I'm, for example, servicing real estate agents, then depending on what I'm selling, I could probably also service real estate brokers as well. There's not a lot of differences in them. I know there's a lot, but for what my service could be, there could not be a whole lot of differences in them. So maybe I wanna add in the parentheses that they can be either a real estate agent or a real estate broker, but I still want them to be they have luxury in them. So they're still servicing luxury homes. So this is an example because it's an or statement of me expanding my search. So let's see if I come in here and I do this, we have 999 results. Let's see what this populates inside of here. So now we have 1,000+ results, okay? So it's grown, it doesn't tell us the exact number, but it's over 1,000 people. So it's probably added a few hundred people to our search results, because now we can go after luxury real estate brokers as well. But we're not done, okay? We have one more here, and this is gonna encompass all five of the different elements of a Boolean search. We have parentheses, we have ands, we have ors, we have nots, and we have quotation marks. So let's say that when we were doing these search results previously, after we made it a little bit larger, we kept on seeing commercial in there. It was like commercial this, commercial that, commercial this, commercial that. And I only help residential real estate agents. Well, what I realized is that most residential real estate agents don't call themselves residential real estate agents in their LinkedIn profile, but I know that they're residential because if they're commercial, then they'll use the word commercial, right? So this is a great example of the not feature inside of LinkedIn, because if I use residential in the quotation marks, I'm gonna really limit down, because a lot of people don't use the word residential. But if there's commercial, in order to help people distinguish them better, almost always they'll use the word commercial. So in this final example here, I say two parentheses, real estate agent or real estate broker, but I don't want the word commercial inside of there, and luxury, right? And then close parentheses. So the first formula and operation they do is that they have to have real estate agent or real estate broker and not commercial. And then once they have that, then they also need the word luxury, right? So let's come back over here. Let's copy this. Let's go back here. We'll delete it. We'll enter, and boom. Now this one should be real estate agents or real estate brokers that are not in the commercial industry that have the word luxury in their title. If you're an online coach, consultant, course creator, or service provider, and you want our help building for you an end-to-end marketing system that brings you these qualified clients on autopilot, guaranteed or your money back, I'd recommend you click the link in the description down below where you can watch a video where we'll be able to walk you through exactly what it's like to work with us.